It's a beautiful country. It's so rich in biological heritage and germplasms that we have. We have enormous number of species of plants and animals which don't exist anywhere else in the world. Number of species of plants and animals which have known properties, therapeutic properties, nutritional properties, and so on, but most of which are still unknown. But we have the wealth. We simply don't know how to use them, how to store them, and how to safe keep them. And it's all destroyed just by a handful of greedy people in power. Biopiracy is simply stealing the intellectual property rights of indigenous people and the genetic material which were developed and kept in custody by these folk scientists, I would say, over centuries. So, in a sense, all these decades after WTO, we have more than 260 biopiracy patents on Indian plant genetic materials. Over these 17 years, I have carried, like a porter, about 20 kg bags of seeds to the doorsteps of the scientists working in different institutions and universities in the entire Eastern India. 18 institutions and laboratories I have visited with the request that you please do all this kind of DNA analysis or the protein banding or the vitamin analysis and so on and so forth, just for the sake of publication, so that it becomes a prior public art, and that will immediately prevent any scope of biopiracy. Till date, we have not received a single letter of acknowledgement.
Growing and saving all these rice varieties on my farm is that I also want to protect them from biopiracy by multinational companies. Basmati, for example, has already been patented by a foreign company. So in order to protect that, I mean, prevent that kind of patenting of farmers' own rice varieties, we are also documenting growing these rice varieties and recording all the characteristics of each variety and copyright them. And that will prevent the patenting in future by any corporation.
So the US Patent Act has one clause, 102, which says that nothing can be patented if it is prior public knowledge. That's very common sense, and that's acceptable everywhere. But here in this clause, they define public as US citizens. Only US citizens are the public. So it doesn't matter if billions of Indians and billions of Africans know the use of any material, know the existence of those germplasms or animals or plants, it doesn't matter, because the Americans don't know it. That's the only reason. The only legal battle that Indian government has won is one single patent on turmeric. But there are still another 3 patents on turmeric which has not yet challenged. The used to have 110,000 rice varieties. I repeat, 110,000 rice varieties in India until 1970s. The estimated number of extant varieties, that is existing number, is not more than 7,000. I have a dream treasure, a wealth, a genetic wealth, which nobody else in this country have in his own possession. I have 1,020 indigenous rice varieties, the entire germplasm stock. And there are many varieties and the properties which are yet unimagined by the genetic engineers of the world. And I am sitting with these varieties. So we are sitting in the middle of nowhere, which is not even connected with electricity. But we are doing some meaningful science, some of which have been published in international peer-reviewed journals too, to prove the credibility of this research. So that explains perhaps the meaning of conservation that we achieve. Conservation of the folk rice genetic materials, conservation of those critically endangered species. Endangered species which have no commercial value, but which has enormous potential value for the future generation, for the posterity, which we cannot imagine today.
Thank you.